Mike here, and in the previous computer science wrap, I pretty much said that variables are very valuable programming tools. So let's review.
Making your first program, sprinkle in some nouns. Those nouns are known as variables. Let's break them down.
Like in that section, I should have said sprinkle in some pronouns. Just as pronouns can be used to take the place of repeated nouns, variables can be used to take the place of repeated data. And if done with other people in mind, the variables that you choose can make it easier for folks to read and understand your code. So instead of naming the variable for a light sensor input super awesome variable name, consider using something sensible and descriptive like light level.
Like a label maker keeping info organized, data can't go into containers without a type.
Variables come in various flavors. Ints, floats, char strings, bools, these are just a few of the types that you'll use. While I rap about what these types are, I didn't quite mention what you can do with them. In addition to belonging to unique data sets, data types are also involved in unique operations. Ints and floats can be used in math operations, like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Booleans can be used in logical operations, using the operators and, or, and not. Strings can be used in string operations, such as concatenation, which combines more than one string. And variables of the same data type can be compared to one another in comparison operations, using the operators greater than, less than, and equals. These operations and operators are just a few that you'll use, which is way less catchy than the original hook. That's why we have the review. That's a free rhyme. Off to the next section.
To make a variable, first declare the type, followed by its name to the right. Make sure that the name isn't senseless. It's a good idea to practice practical naming conventions.
When you declare a variable, there's a lot going on behind the scenes. You're essentially reserving some amount of computer memory to store information. And the amount of memory reserved is based on the data type of the variable. And when you call the variable later, like printing the value of super awesome variable name, that name is then used as a reference to the variable's location in memory and the information that it holds, making it very convenient to work with computer memory.
Bam, you conjured up a variable. Without variables, coding would be terrible.
All right, check this out. This is some exclusive information. There will be times when you need to work with outside data, coming from people, external files, or sensors. Since we don't know the value of the data in advance, we can use variables as placeholders to catch the information, allowing us to abstract or generalize the data. Hang on with me, check it out. If there was a program that worked in calculating the price per square inch of a pizza, but only worked for a 20-inch $20 pizza, that'd be pretty useless. There's only one answer. But if that program were designed to use variables for the size and price as inputs, we could catch any range of sizes and prices. We go from being able to work with just one pizza to any pizza, highlighting another benefit of using variables. Variables allow us to work with a range of inputs, making programs way more flexible.
We got ints, floats, char strings, bools. These are just a few of the types that you use. Ints, floats, char strings, bools. These are just a few of your programming tools.
So like I said in the intro, variables are very valuable programming tools. I hope this video helped you understand data types and variables a little bit better. If you learned something new, consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching, and don't forget your ABCs. Always be coding.